Hello everyone! We at PalmSens do electrochemistry every day, but sometimes it's still good to go back to fundamental terminology and just check what you know. Do you know what redox potential is? Well, if I look it up, it says it's the tendency for a species, so a molecule or maybe in a metal surface, to take up or donate electrons. That's very abstract. Maybe let's look at an example. Let's immerse a metal sheet here in gray in this blue solution. And what happens is the positive part of the atoms, the protons and neutrons, they go as positive particles into the solution. Why do they do that? Well, the water is forming a little cushion, a little shell around it, which is energetically very preferable. So, while they do that, they leave behind the negatively charged electrons charging up the metal. That is then again attracting these positive particles who are now in the electric field of their own metal. So they come back, but then again there's the solvation pressure. So to go out and be surrounded by that nice shell from the water. And every metal is finding there a different equilibrium. It's a dynamic equilibrium, like most things in chemistry. So you end up with a specific charge for every metal. You can even see that for different metals that's different. Just take two different metal sheets and put them in the same solution. Now connect them via a voltmeter, or maybe perform an open circuit potentiometry with your potentiostat. And you can see that the voltage difference between these two metals is not zero. What can we do with that? Well, for example, you could already run a light or something else with this, because you can use that potential difference for powering other devices, because it's basically a battery. You connect the two metals and electrons will start flowing from the metal that has more negative charge to the metal that has less negative charge. It goes from the more negative potential to the more positive potential. Now, we're scientists, we want to understand this, we want to categorize this, so we want to make lists of potential differences. And you can actually nicely make lists due to one property. The potential differences are additive. What does that mean? Well, if we have three different metals and we metal between copper and lead and between lead and zinc, the potential differences, we can actually calculate the potential difference between copper and zinc because it's just, well, the sum of the two other ones. Now, we can make long lists with like all these potential differences. No, we can do something better. We agree on a zero point and we only have to list for each metal one potential. We have agreed, just as a convention, that the reduction of hydrogen is our zero point. And this way we can make long lists with like all the different potentials. It does not only work for metals, also for other molecules. Now you know what the redox potential is. If you want to measure your redox potential, well, you can just use our potentiostats for open circuit potentiometry measurements. Any of our potentiostats can do that, even the very compact and small ones like the SensiT Smart or the SensiT BT. Thanks for watching and have a great day.